Alright, welcome back. This is part 27 of our playthrough, so we are still in the prison. We are still completely unarmed. Still lost our flashlights and everything. I guess we can use a fire extinguisher as a weapon. So I think what we need to do here, if we don't want to fight all of these freaking guys, which I don't think we do, is to use these lights to push them into where we want them to go. Still, no, there's not, so we just want to, no, go the other way. Corral these guys over here so that they won't bother us. And then they should stay there. Except now I'm thinking, yeah, we should be able to go down this way. They won't bother us because they're pinned in there by the light. This guy will, however, so no, that is a bad idea. So I think what we want to do is push them all into the next area, close the gate with the lever up here, and then we can go down and start exploring. Let's try this again. Back, motherfucker. Wow, you do not want to go where I want you to, do you? That's like two of the three. No, don't come back. There we go. That's all of them into the main area. We can go close the gate. And we should now be semi-safe. I assume we're gonna have to go that way. So, yeah. But I'm fairly certain that's what we were supposed to do to start. What do we have here? We got a sledgehammer. I guess that'll be a bit better. Oh. Can we open this door? Yes, we can. It's just a lock. They are still all pinned in there, so we're still good. No one can get to us here. I wish I had my flashlight, but I guess they took that away because it would have just not made too much sense. This is a completely pointless area, it seems. I'm gonna guess we have to use this other light that seems to be on the blink here. Yeah, okay. No, 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 no. So we want to use this light to, again, put all of them into that main pen. Even though this one's on the fritz, and then just,
Wait, no. Come on, damn it. Work!
Okay. I wonder if you can even kill these guys, because... Come on. You're gonna cut out just before they get there again. Well, this isn't annoying or anything. Stay there. Okay, at least. Damn it. Okay, at least once you get them in there, they seem to just kind of aggro into that zone and stay there. Otherwise, this would have been real hard. Pull it before you come back. Thank you. I think we should now be able to get out of here. Like I said in the last episode, I think we're pretty much nearing the end of the game. We didn't do all the side quests, we didn't find all the paintings, we didn't find all the shadow things. I said from the start, this was not a walkthrough, this was just a let's play. I might go back, but I don't know. I think I'm good with just playing through this again this way. Flashlight would still be awesome. I have no idea where we're supposed to go. Oh, okay, wait. I think we have to go where it came from. Oh, not the time. Really not the time. Oh, okay, no, we have to go up. Oh, come on, fuck off. And of course, you put one of those right there. shotgun back. Put that on our back. Med pack. Okay, can't interact with that one. This way. Hopefully you guys have figured out who the big wheelchair mommy monster thing is by now. Oh, come on. Really? We're gonna take this hit too, I think. Wow. I think I'm doing this right, but I'm not gonna guarantee. So I think we missed that on the other side. Ah, got it. Fun. make a game that has combat, at least make it fun. I don't know. I don't think that's asking too much, you know? Oh yay, more enemies that we don't want to fight because they're fucking boring to fight. Come on, fuckface. I mean, there's no lock-on mechanic in this game. You just kind of swing and hope for the best. Block and hope for the best. Okay, fuck off then. You don't even want to fight me. I don't want to fight you. That kind of sucks. Yay, more shitty monsters we don't want to fight. And we're gonna die here, aren't we? Really, I'm swinging through you and it's doing nothing! Sledgehammer, because it takes half an hour to swing in. It's also the fact that the weapons don't even seem balanced. You can hit someone with a lead pipe and it seems to do as much damage as the like sledgehammer, even though the sledgehammer takes half an hour to swing. Now, I think we're just literally running our way around, fighting these ass clowns, just to get back to the other side of what we're actually trying to do here. Just rinse and repeat and ride the respirators up. Stunning light. Down, unplug, rinse, repeat. I assume there's four of them, so this should be next to last. It's not even like we have a dodge move or anything in this goddamn game either, so. The ideas and stories and stuff behind Silent Hill I find really good, but like, the combat is just garbage. And you can see why they're not going to make any more Silent Hills, but they're definitely going to be making more Resident Evil games, especially after 7, which was just a bit insane. Dead yet, fuckface? He's dead. Finally. Just in case he wasn't dead enough, let's just crush him with the tower. And who was the creepy? Well, it was our friend Napier.
How could you?
What?
He was a good man. A good man!
What the hell are you talking about? That thing tried to kill me. It's not a man, it's a monster.
My bad. I did think it was going to be Napier, but alright, I guess not.
That's not what I agreed to.
Murphy? Is that you?
Officer Coleridge?
Jeez, I'm glad it's just you. This thing is kicking off something fierce. I knew you'd be smart enough to steer clear of it.
What are you doing here?
Sewell told me to meet him here. You haven't seen him, have you? He ain't answering his radio.
Don't do it, Murphy.
Are you okay, Murph? You don't look so good. What's that you got there? What the hell's going on, Murphy?
No. This isn't what I agreed to.
What are you talking about? Agreed to what?
Tell him, Murph.
What's going on here, Sewell? Why didn't you answer the radio?
Should have learned to keep your big fucking mouth shut, Frank. Now my friend Murphy's got to shut it for you.
Murphy, don't do this.
Come on, Murphy, you gonna keep your end of the bargain or not? Do it,
Murphy.
You son of a bitch!
No!
No.
You know, he was a great man, my dad. Didn't matter who you were, family, friends, even prisoners. He treated everyone with respect.
I didn't do it.
Always looking for the positive side of people. I wanted to be just like him.
You don't understand. Your father treated me like one of his own.
He didn't die right away, you know. After you were done beating the life out of him, he spent years in that wheelchair. A fucking vegetable. Did you know that? And I had to watch this. This wonderful man shit and piss all over himself, day after day after day. And every time I looked at him, you know what I saw?
Listen to me.
I saw a monster. I saw you.
Just calm down a minute and let me tell you what really happened.
You don't know how many strings I had to pull to get your transfer approved, to get you to my prison. The favors I had to call in, the sick things I had to do to get you under my watch.
You don't have to do this.
My father was a good man. He didn't believe in revenge. But I do.
I don't know if she can even kill you.
Why won't you
with those
die?
Shots, but I doubt it. Apparently, I never got that achievement.
You'll pay for what you did.
On, but I think this is basically going to be the end, so I guess we're going to be done. So I'm not going to cut this off. We're just going to finish this off in this episode. Might be a double episode, but we're basically at the end, I think. So we're going to spare her, because we want to get the good ending. And it seems like we didn't actually kill her dad, because we've got enough good karma from the actions and things we did during the game. I think we should get probably the best ending we can get.
No! I won't do it.
Yeah, I thought you might say that.
No!
Jesus, you're pathetic. What about Napier? The guy kills your boy. You go through all the trouble of getting yourself locked up with him, and what happens? I serve him to you like a fucking Christmas goose, and you can't even finish the job. No, I gotta go in there and finish the bastard off for you. I ask for one little favor in return.
Murphy, run!
And this is the thanks I get!
Frank!
Put your hands where I can see them.
You son of a
bitch. I'm not gonna tell you again. Sewell here. We got an officer down. 10-00, C block, shower level, over.
You can't do this.
I didn't. Whose prints do you think are on that ship?
10-4, backup's on its way. Sit tight.
Roger that. Should've just kept your end of the deal, Murph. Cop killers don't last too long in here.
I'm sorry, Frank. I'm sorry, Frank.
It wasn't you.
It was my fault he died.
Pendleton.
I'm so sorry.
I forgive you.
This. Are we free?
Yeah. I think we are.
All units respond. YL Prison DOC bus involved in a TC. Fatalities eastbound 73. Fire and rescue en route.
I should go.
I guess you better. Wait. Where are you going?
There's some place I gotta be.
Murphy, wait. Thank you.
For what?
The truth.
Him in the neck now.
Hey, what are you doing back here so soon, sweetheart? Can't get enough of the place. The hell's this?
You used to work with my father, Frank Coleridge.
Yeah, so?
We need to talk.
Oh, snap. So there we go. That is the end of our playthrough of Silent Hill Downpour. That was the best possible ending you can actually get for the game. There are many others. Silent Hill always has the weird dog ending and always has a weird, like, alien surprise ending or something like that. Just to go over quick, I guess, basically we got the best ending because we picked the good choices every time we got prompted. We freed the bird with 5 birds, which I think is increasing our karma as well. You can't see your karma anywhere, it's just something that's calculated in the back end. We're gonna skip this because I don't want any copyright strikes for music. But yeah, and then basically we defeated, but we did spare her, which gave us the good possible ending. I think if you do all the bad choices and everything, you actually killed Napier, you actually killed her dad. But I've never actually done it. I think there's achievements for it as well. But there you go, that is the end. That is our playthrough of Silent Hill Downpour. Hopefully you enjoyed. Let me know if there's another game you guys want me to play. If not, I think I'm just going to take a break from these Let's Plays for a while. So, there you go.